the Kerala government has decided to allot over 18 acres of land and 2 crore rupees seed capital to build a space park in the state's capital city, Thiruvananthapuram. A space park gives space tech companies the platform to manufacture space technology. They provide the ecosystem and expertise for research and manufacturing. Most private companies don't have the capital and resources to establish such a park on their own.
What would it be? A space park, as I would say, would be a combination of a technology park and an economic zone. It would provide the basic backbone of, say, broadband, infrastructure, conference halls, testing facilities which can be used by multiple players, then multiple domain players of different verticals of space can be at one place. And a great opportunity to startups who do not have their own infrastructures but can use this facility to grow.
Kerala had announced the space park plan back in 2019. Vikram Sarabhai Space Center was supposed to lead the development, but administrative and technical issues delayed this project. The government had initially allotted 2 acres of land, which was not sufficient for such a project.
You need land. Otherwise, where will you start manufacturing? And aerospace manufacturing is not electronics manufacturing that you can have a, you know, 5, 6, 7 story building, and in that you can do what you want to do. Here you need space, right? And then you also need to transport. So for transportation, you need, when we go forward in any aerospace park, you need a runway so that aircrafts can land. I'm not talking about the particular one, but generally all aerospace and space parks need a runway. So this means that there is a great requirement of land. Initially, I think just about 2 acres of land was allotted to begin with. And Vikram Sarabhai Space Center obviously wanted more. They also wanted to build a space museum.
According to Ratan Srivastava, considering Kerala's geography, which naturally has a shortage of land, finding and allotting land was difficult and became a hindrance for the space park to take off. But things are changing for the better now, and the private sector too has been allowed to operate in this sphere. For a long time, ISRO was the sole stakeholder that had been manufacturing launch vehicles and satellites and providing infrastructure for space missions in the country. But the space business and demand for space technology has been growing all across the globe, and it was important to allow private companies to carry out independent space activities. So, in June 2020, the central government decided to open up the space sector for private companies. Since then, more and more private players have been entering the space tech sector in India. According to ISPA, the Indian Space Association, India now has more than 300 registered private space companies. Of them, 101 are startups. Dhruva Space Private Limited, Agnikul Cosmos, Skyroot Aerospace, Pixel, Digantara and Azista Aerospaces are some of the private companies that are in the space tech industry in India. Skyroot Aerospace developed the first privately developed rocket, Vikram S, and launched it last November. India's first ever private launch pad facility has been designed by Agnikul Cosmos and will be ready to launch rockets from this year. Two more private manufacturers from India, Dhruva Space and Digantara, have already launched their payloads last year. Azista, another Hyderabad-based aerospace company, has joined hands with a German aerospace company called Berlin Space Technology and developed a satellite production capacity in Ahmedabad. It was reported that the private aerospace companies invested a total of $108 million in India last year. It is a considerable amount when compared to the $1.5 billion of total budget for the space sector in India. So far, two manufacturing clusters have been announced in India. Apart from the one in Kerala, the other one is in Karnataka. Karnataka was the first to announce a state-led aerospace park near Kempegowda International Airport in 2016. It was named Karnataka Industrial Area Development Board Aerospace Park. In June 2022, Anant Technologies started a spacecraft manufacturing unit in this space park. In November 2022, another private company, Bellatrix, announced a research and development facility worth $76 million in a 5-acre facility at the Karnataka Aerospace Park. According to reports, another state that is moving towards setting up the same kind of manufacturing cluster is Telangana. So, how will these common infrastructure clusters, like the ones in Kerala and Karnataka, help private companies, especially startups?
The space park is also being based out of Trivandrum, Kerala, which is also the same city as the Vikram Sarabhai Space Center. we expect that Vikram Sarabhai Space Center being the largest center in the ISRO ecosystem. So it will get a lot of benefit, technical help, and also guidance and assistance from the largest ISRO center, right? And its scientists. So that way, like technically also, it will be like very relevant, and also like the timing wise also it is relevant if they're able to establish common infrastructure for all the startups.
Also, how is the Kerala Space Park project progressing, and how will it help private players?
As I said, well begun is half done. This is just the beginning. The other challenges would also be for the Kerala state government to give offices on lien, on loan, on contract to the government of to VSSC and to the SPV, because we cannot expect VSSC scientists to be doing all the administrative running around and getting things in order and getting the construction done. So all those things will need a lot of effort, political administrative effort from the government of Kerala as well as from KSIITL. And of course, VSSC will be willing to do whatever needs to be done.
Despite the challenges of building such an ecosystem, space parks are crucial as they have the potential to give Indian space technology a boost. As a result, India could even become an exporter of such technology and services. But before that, it is clear that complex administrative and technical challenges will have to be surmounted.
If you like this video, share it and subscribe to Business Standard. For more news, views and insights, log on to www.business-standard.com. Do also follow us on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Telegram and LinkedIn.